powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad. I have a word for you today, and I believe that this word is going to set things in motion as your faith rises to another level beyond restoration. God is not only going to restore, but God will exceed restoration. He will not just restore the things you lost, but he's going to bring more as a proof that his covenant has not failed and cannot fail beyond restoration. Most times in life, we lose things or as a result of situation or the enemy comes and there are things we lose: relationship, job, business, maybe ministry. Sometimes people lose most important things to them. But God is saying beyond restoration. You should have a vision bigger than what you have lost. Whatever you have lost in the past, or whatever you felt that was taken away from you, you should have a vision bigger than that, because God is bringing more than restoration. He doesn't want it to end at the level of restoration. He wants you to come into new dimension. He wants you to come into a new phase of your life where you can experience unusual expansion. You see, God doesn't want to just give you what you're used to. He also wants to give you what you are not used to. For that reason, there has to be a clarity of vision beyond what you lost 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 2 months ago, 3 months ago, 5 days ago, 2 days ago, 1 day ago, 5 seconds ago. Whatever you have lost in the past, God wants you to have a vision bigger than it. When you have a vision bigger than that, God will not only bring restoration, he will help you to experience expansion. It is supernatural expansion. It's like you're being compensated for the years of you lost those things. For the years you lost those things, God began to bring compensation. You're compensated, and new doors are open to experience unlimited expansion. So God is bringing beyond restoration. So in this season, you need to have a vision that is bigger than what you lost 5 years ago. Maybe it was a marriage that was lost. Maybe the one you trusted so much walked away from you. You can have a picture. You can have a dream of something bigger and better than what you've lost in the past. Our God is not just a God of restoration. He's also a God of new things. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. Maybe you lost a job and this job used to give you like $3,000 every month or $4,000 every month. Can you picture a job in your spirit that will give you $5,000, $10,000 every month? Can you picture that? Can you see that in your spirit? Can you see, maybe you lost your home, you lost your house. Can you see something bigger than that? Can you use your imagination to make a way for greater things to take place? Can I say this to you? What you lost cannot be compared to what God is bringing. Whatever you have lost in the past, whatever they took away from you, whatever they took from you, whatever you have lost in the past cannot be compared to what God is bringing into your life. This is the reason why you shouldn't give up. This is the reason why you shouldn't quit. This is the reason why you shouldn't doubt the prophecies that has been released towards your life. This is the reason why you shouldn't give up on yourself and tell yourself, this is the end of the road for me. This is the reason you need to step out by faith and believe God for great things. He said, behold, I will do a new thing and it will spring forth. Can you see the harvest? Can you take away all the limitation, all the confections that are not consistent with God's word, all the thinking, all the imagination that did not line up with God's word? Can you see there is a mighty harvest coming? The scripture said, except the corn of the wheat falls to the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it dies, and is going to bring forth more fruit. And there is someone watching this broadcast right now. The Lord said, beyond restoration. This is a prophetic word for you. Beyond restoration. God is not going to only restore. He will exceed your imagination. Ephesians 3 verse 20. He said, now unto him that is able to do exceeding. He said, God wants to exceed your expectation. But the question is, are you ready to receive beyond your expectation? God wants to exceed your expectation. Are you allowing where you are to define your future? Where you are is not your destiny. What you have lost is not your destiny. What they took from you is not your destiny. Your life is beyond the opposition and the challenges that came against you. So it doesn't matter what is happening right now. I hear God saying, beyond restoration. So if because God wants to do beyond restoration, he expects you to have a vision that is more than where you are. He expects you to have a vision bigger than where you are. So no matter where you are right now, can you see something big coming? Can you see something great coming? Can you see beyond your imagination? Let me say this to you. The scripture said, the just shall live by faith. If you're going to see beyond restoration, then your faith need to rise. You need to rise in faith and begin to see the harvest. Begin to prophesy the harvest. Begin to call those things that be not as though they were. Clarity of vision, faith in God. These are key strategies. Clarity of vision, faith in God. What will faith in God do? Faith in God helps you to receive the pictures of the future. You see the picture with clarity that my future is bright. Then you begin to declare, I have a new job. I have a well-paying job. I have a great job. I have a great business. I have a great opportunity. Your declaration is coming because you have revelation of what God is about to do beyond your expectation. Can you expect miracles? Can you expect supernatural intervention? This is not the end of the road for you. You are not going to die in debt. You are not going to die broke. You will fulfill your destiny. You will step into the place that God has ordained for you beyond restoration. God is not only going to restore, but God will exceed your expectation. God is not going to only do the things you ask for. God is also going to do the things he has intended to do for you. You know, God doesn't only give us our need, but God is also interested in bringing our wants our way. Maybe your need right now is to drive a very little car, maybe something you could manage, but your want may be to drive the latest Range Rover 2017. But God also wants to supply your wants. He's not only interested in your need, He also wants to supply your wants. There is someone watching this broadcast right now, and the Lord is saying, beyond restoration, I will not only restore what you're asking for, I will exceed your expectation. Maybe it's your children. Maybe they have gone far away from you. They are not calling you. They are not returning home. Let me say this to you. God is going to restore more than what you ask for. You know, sometimes in our life, it looks like we have lost everything. It looks like nothing is happening. But suddenly, bam, 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 it's just coming. It's just coming. It's just coming. You remember many years ago when you used to be homeless. You remember many years ago when you lost your job. You remember many years ago when you had a heartbreak. You remember many years ago when they walked you out because no one cared. But suddenly, the story changer stepped into your life. I hear this in my spirit today, beyond restoration. Oh, somebody's watching this broadcast right now. And the Holy Ghost is saying, are you expecting? Are you believing? Are you thinking in this direction? Beyond your expectation. God will exceed your expectation. There is someone watching this broadcast. I hear God say, write out your dreams. Write out your testimonies. What are the testimonies you want to testify? Look for a diary and write out your testimony and say, in the name of Jesus, I testify I have paid off the home. In the name of Jesus, I testify I have paid off the car. In the name of Jesus, I testify my sons and daughters are back home. In the name of Jesus, I testify my job has been restored to me with new paycheck. In the name of Jesus, you go ahead and write your testimony and testify to yourself and begin to praise God with the testimony. Begin to say, God, I thank you. It doesn't matter where I am right now, my victory is sure. My victory is sure. The devil is going to have a nervous breakdown because God will not only restore, He will exceed your expectation. There is someone watching this broadcast right now. And the word of the Lord came to me, and that word of the Lord is in Philippians 1 verse 6. He said, he who has begun a good work in you, he said he will bring it to completion. He has started a good work in you. This is the time to praise God. This is not the time to sit down and lie down on the bed and begin to cry and begin to weep. That is not what to do. That is not what to do. Even if you're emotional about the whole situation, even if you're feeling frustrated, this is know what to do. Tears will not bring you out of the situation, but faith in God will. Faith in God will. Faith in God will bring you out of the pain, out of the shame, out of the humiliation. I refuse to cry. I refuse to be depressed. I refuse to worry because I am expecting beyond restoration. I am expecting beyond restoration. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. He has begun a good work in you. Philippians 1 verse 6, he said he will bring it to conclusion. He's going to conclude what he has started. The word that God gave to you 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, this is a harvest season. I hear this clear in my spirit. I'm not supposed to be here teaching right now. I was just relaxing, and then the Lord begins to give me this word in my spirit, you know. He said, I wanted to go out there and minister my word to my people. So this is why I'm here. I'm already done with my day job. And he said, I wanted to tell them beyond restoration, I will not only restore, I will bring expansion. I will bring increase. I will bring multiplication. I will bring preferential treatment. I will bring supernatural harvest. There is someone watching this broadcast right now. And the Holy Ghost is saying, this is not the time to worry. But this is the time to smile. This is not the time to worry, because you've been worrying. Last night you couldn't sleep very well. A lady, you're watching me. Last night you couldn't sleep very well. You know, you lost your sleep and you're worrying. You say, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? Hear ye the word of the Lord. I've gone ahead of you and the harvest is coming in. Oh, glory be to God. I have a prophetic word for the person. In Amos chapter 9, verse 13. This is a word for someone watching me. Amos chapter 9, verse 13. He said, behold, the days come, said the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reapers, and the traders of grapes him that soweth seed, and the mountain shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. And I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel, and they shall build the wasted cities and inhabit them. And they shall plant vineyard and drink the wine thereof. They shall also make gardens and eat the fruit thereof. And I will plant them upon their land, and they shall no more be pulled out of their land, which I have given them, said the Lord thy God. Now, this is Amos chapter 9 from verse 13. Amos chapter 9 from verse 13. And I think I have the Message translation here. Let me try to read it from the Message translation, if I have the Message, because I needed to read this. Amos chapter 9 from verse 13. This is a very powerful word. This is a very powerful word. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, lika pradoske tolika paparando seketolika bababa. Rico tobo seketolibra do seketolibaba. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Okay, in Amos chapter 9, verse 13, look at what he said here. Amos 9, 13, he said, yes, indeed, it won't be long now. God's decree. Things are going to happen so fast, your head will swim. Wow. Things are going to happen so fast that your head will swim. Wow, I like that. One thing on the heel of another, you won't be able to keep up. Everything will be happening at once, and everywhere you look, blessing. Blessing like a wine pouring off the mountains and the hills. This is powerful. Pouring down the mountains and the hill, and I will make everything right again for my people Israel. They will rebuild their ruined cities, and they'll plant vineyard and drink good wine. They will walk their gardens and eat fresh vegetable. I like that. Verse 15 said, And I will plant them on their own land. They will never again be uprooted from the land I have given them. God, your God, says so. You know, this is from the Message translation. So, someone watching this broadcast, expect beyond your imagination. You know, the Spirit of God is doing amazing things. And I hear this in my spirit. You don't have to worry about it. You just have to begin to declare your victory by faith and expect supernatural miracle and expect supernatural open door. There is someone you've been watching. You're watching this broadcast. And the Holy Ghost said, there was no need for you to cry. There was no need for you to be depressed. There was no need for you to feel frustrated, because your seed is in the ground and your harvest is coming forth. Your seed is in the ground and your harvest is coming forth. Your seed is in the ground and your harvest is coming forth. So this is not a time to worry, but this is the time to declare your victory. This is the time to shout from the housetop and say, God, I thank you because you have done it. God, I thank you because I'm in my season beyond restoration. Beyond restoration. Someone watching right now, this is the word of the Lord to you. Write it bold. Beyond restoration. I am in a season of beyond restoration. This is a prophetic word for someone right now. I am in a season of beyond restoration. It's a season. It's an era. You have just stepped into a season of beyond restoration. So from this day forward, don't just expect things to be restored. Expect beyond restoration. You will not only receive things being restored back to you, but new things new things, new opportunities, new blessings, new increase, new platform, new relationship, new platform. Someone is coming to love you. Someone is coming to celebrate you. Someone is coming to add to your life. Someone is coming to stand by your dream beyond restoration. God will not only restore, but God is bringing something new, something better, something great, something beautiful into your life beyond restoration. This is your harvest season. This is your time. This is your hour. This is your moment. He's not just going to do small things around you. He's going to do great things in your life. He's going to do amazing things in your life. Expect miracles. Expect supernatural provision. Expect emails. Emails of opportunity. Expect phone calls that will change your story. I prophesy to you, amazing open door from the west, from the east, from the north, from the south. In the name of Jesus, I decree divine connection, new relationship, divine connection. The right kind of people are coming into your life and they are moving things forward. They are opening the doors. They are opening the doors in the name of Jesus. Beyond restoration. I can hear this in my spirit. It is your jubilee. It is your jubilee. It is your jubilee. It is your jubilee. It's time to shout. It's time to praise God. It's time to say, God, I thank you. It is your jubilee. It is your jubilee. Can you see the harvest? Can you see the doors open? Can you see the miracles taking place? Can you see new destiny? Can you see new horizon? What can you see in the spirit? It is your jubilee, says the Lord. Father, we thank you. Beyond your expectation. Beyond your expectation is taking place. Beyond your imagination. Beyond your imagination. God is going to exceed your imagination. God is going to exceed your expectation. God is going to exceed your thoughts, the things you desired, the things you wrote. He will exceed it because you are in a season of beyond expectation, beyond restoration, because this is a new season, this is a new hour, this is a new time, and expect miracles, expect increase, expect preferential treatment, expect doors to open in high places. I prophesy to you, they will look for you, they will look for you, they will call you back, they will give you a call. Can you do this job for us? Can you do this business for us? I decree and I declare that it's your time for a new song, it's your time for something new, it's your time for extraordinary miracle, because in this season, God will exceed your expectation. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lamb of God. Wow. Someone watching this broadcast, the anointing just came upon you right now. Receive in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Something just came upon you. That's the power of God. Receive from this day forward, and you're going to see supernatural opportunity, preferential treatment. I decree and I declare that in this season, you'll be betting new things. You'll be bringing forth new harvest, new platform, new things are happening. Yes, I said before you, an open door, and no man can shut it. This is the season where no man can shut it. Go ahead and swim in abundance, abundance of favor, abundance of provision, abundance of divine connection, abundance of healing, abundance of supernatural help. This is your season. The story changer is working for your good. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, amen. If you're watching this broadcast today, it's a joy to be here with you today. And if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with me, it means you're born again and you will not remain the same. Your best of days are ahead of you and you will not remain the same. We love you. Hallelujah. Now, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. And I'd like you to tell your friends and your loved ones, your husband, your wife, your children, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your cousin, your nephew, whoever that is your friend, your relation, tell them about subscribe to Faithman Teaching on YouTube. There is a lot of teaching out there, more than 1,000 videos, and so much revelation is coming every day to people around the nation. So much revelation is coming. So go to Faithman Teaching on YouTube and just connect with us, and you will not remain listening. Now, I want to encourage you also to keep go ahead and share the videos. Go ahead and share the videos. I want to encourage you to keep watching finishworktv.com. Finishworktv is a ministry that is on the cutting edge, helping people around the world. So keep watching finishworktv. It is 24/7 every day. finishworktv.com. When you get there, there is so much. Make sure you drop me a word on finishworktv. Send me an email. Go to the email page. Write your testimony. Share something with me. Let me know how this message is impacting you, because you are here for such a time like this. You're welcome. And also want to encourage you to consider partnering with this ministry. You know, partnering with this ministry helps us to be able to reach out to more people around the world. So you can partner with me today on PayPal. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. You can partner with me on PayPal. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. So we encourage you to partner. Sow a seed today. Support this work today. Tell me, Apostle, I want to stand with you in the ministry as you can reach out to the nation. People are watching us from Hong Kong. They're watching us from Indonesia. They're watching us from Ghana. They're watching us from Benin Republic. They're watching us from Russia. They're watching from Canada. They're watching from Netherlands. They're watching from the US. They're watching from the UK. You know, the message is going everywhere. I want to say thank you to my friends and partners all over the world, those who are connecting with me, ministry, supporting, ensuring that this message is crossing the nation. With your gift and your love and prayers, together, we are changing history and empowering the destinies of many around the world. So we encourage you to consider partnering today and let us change the lives of more people around the world. Someone just sent a text. He said, your teaching has changed my life. That's beautiful. I don't know the country where you're watching me from, but when I see your country, I'll be very glad if you can put your country on the screen where you're watching this broadcast. You know, when I hear the testimonies of people around the world that are watching how their life, their businesses were restored, their marriages were restored, it gives me so much joy. You know, somebody's watching from Central Florida, and that was a very powerful testimony. I'm so happy that you're watching me from Central Florida today, and you will not remain the same. Thank you for watching this broadcast. You can also reach out to me on Facebook. It's Faithman Ogboada on Facebook. Make sure you tell your friends about the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada. Thank you for watching this broadcast. Until I come your way soon, don't forget this. There is a greatness in you.